Hey guys, so I'm Rahul, and I'm here to talk about how you internationalize AngularJS. So Angular does a pretty good job of localizing your date formats, your time formats, your currency. They have built-in filters for currency, and if you use like short date, long date, it automatically resolves based on the locale through the $locale service. But where Angular falls short natively is when you need to translate your app or you want to support multiple languages, whether it's English, French, German, Japanese, right? So that's when you need to turn to like a third-party solution or build your own solution where you can deploy your app and target users across different regions in the globe, right? So my proposal is to go with a really simple architecture. I've built this open source library that I'll provide the link later on. But it's a really simple architecture. The core is a service that provides an API that lets you get a localized string. You can set up which languages you support. And then it's just a question of using a filter or a directive to just bind all your templates with the localization service instead of hard coding your strings directly in the application. So the directory structure is really simple. You have another language folder. In the folder, you have a subfolder, which is each language you want to support. And under that, I've decided to split up my modules or routes just to make your files, your JSON files, much smaller. And then each JSON file looks a little bit like that, where it's the key, which is any unique key for that module, which is a localization key. And then the value would be the string that you want to display in that language. So in this case, cancel refers to cancel in English, which would translate to the French version of cancel if you decide to support French, right? So this is just a little bit about the service, which I already went over. Right? Let's go into some live examples. Right? So obviously, you can just call the service directly and say get localized string. But that's not something we want to do because we load the files dynamically, and sometimes the files may not be loaded. So you'll have a race condition. So what you'd like to use is a filter, for example. And this filter, I have an example here. Okay, never mind. So the filter is really dead simple, right? It's just the way we classify tokens is the part before the dot is the file name, and the part after the dot is the key within that file, right? So in this case, I want to translate comment.hello world based on whatever language the I18N service has detected your user is in, and you can always provide a way for the user to choose his language through a drop-down selector and persist that in a cookie or through local storage. Let's see if any of these work. Okay, so filters are not performant, as we all know, because every time the digest cycle runs, it will refresh all the filters. So we prefer using a directive, which will basically bind once. But the advantage is that if the user changes the language dynamically halfway through the app, the bindings will change. With bind once, which was introduced in 1.3, it binds once and then it doesn't watch anymore. So if we change the language, you'll have to manually trigger a refresh of the page. Now, there's also a couple of other useful things you can do, like inline substitutions. So for example, you have this percentage full name token in the key. And so you pass in the full name to the filter, or you pass in like another data attribute to the directive, and it will automatically replace the contents of that value in place of the token. So you'll get an output. You can play around with all these examples after. I don't know why it's freezing up. I'll give you the link to the slides. The other thing you can do is also have localized string attributes, right? So a lot of times the placeholder, you don't want to use interpolation, or if you're using UI Bootstrap, the tooltip directive takes a string to display in the tooltip, and you want to make sure that all of these are also localized within your app. So you pass in this I18N attribute directive takes a map, which is basically the key is the attribute you want to localize, and the value is the token that will translate to the key and the value in the language, the same way the I18N directive works. The only difference is that instead of updating the text, it will update the attribute value. And I also support pluralization through the ng-pluralize directive. So this is kind of the same thing as the ng-pluralize example on the Angular page. If you notice, I just do pluralization strings and I pipe it to the filter. So based on the count in the same way ng-pluralize works, we will output, whether 0, you'll output one string. If it's 1, you'll output another string. And if it's anything more than one, you'll output a third string, right? And the last thing I support is gender. So gender is pretty straightforward. I know there's maybe more than two genders that, you know, Facebook and other social networks support. But a really simple example using ng-switch. Again, you can use either a directive with ng-if or a filter with ng-switch or interchange them. But you just pipe it through the filter or you bind it to the directive. And then based on the value that you provide the gender with, the system will automatically pick up the localized value of the gender that you want to display. So that's about all the time we have. I also had this helper library, but you guys can look at the slides and understand that more. But this is basically a link to the slides, and I have a bigger meetup session that I did, and I have a link to those slides as well. That's about it.